If you're speaking about the same dream, first of all, you didn't see me hiding anything today. Clearly implicating those families who controlled well and finance certain things. And I would say, if you can speak about them, don't speak about them being Jewish. You must speak about which fraternity they belong to. And I tried to have that conversation a few times, and I had to get blown over. Just to follow up on another thing.
See, one thing we gotta understand, man, what Harry is doing is trying to separate Jewish people from white folks. All white people are damn white people.
No.
It don't matter. Yes, it don't matter. They all come from the Kansas Hills of Europe. Some women are that way, some women are that way. You're all the same people, man. Stop playing games. We got a problem here. You're dealing with the unique people here, man.
That attitude won't lead towards organic consciousness. By you saying a certain color of human is evil, a certain color of human is righteous, that is not the solution.
Are black people devils? I'm not asking for like...
Oh, shit. Yeah. Yeah, get up in here, sir.
Okay.
I want to know, how can we get people on the path of my eye more and better than ourselves as individuals? Because after the bar for knowledge, we have to basically work on ourselves as individuals. Because when we take the stand, that's what matters the most. Our character.
Self-image.
So I say, as far as getting on the path of my ad walk, we live in a world where some people's preference deal with prayer, some deal with meditation of preference, and some introspect. I say introspection is the true line between the two, and we need to couple our prayers with meditation. Because of the tilt that the planet Earth is on, we tend to lean to one side more than the other. You know, toilets are flush counterclockwise on the eastern hemisphere, the western hemisphere clockwise. It still goes on the left overhead, on the right side over here. More people are left-handed over there, more people are right-handed over there. It's the tilt of the planet Earth, and the inability for us to travel has been handicapping us as a people. Because traveling opens up new experiences and corridors of consciousness. So we find half the planet is dealing with an obesity issue, which is where we are. And then if you go and you travel east, they're dealing with a skinny issue over there from being malnutrition, even though malnutrition is exclusive to being skinny, right? So what we gotta come to terms with is the importance of exploring information in different places. And understanding not to be selective with very quality metaphysical medicine, meaning on one side of the planet, meditation to higher reference and breathing exercises. They're not talking. On this side of the planet, in order to raise a certain level of awareness or cognizance about something or pertinent matters pertaining to spirituality, we preach, we lecture, we speak. On the other side, they're breathing and they're meditating. We should apply both faculties. When we achieve that in ourselves first, then we can apply it to our family, our community abroad, and then we can start talking to the world community.
Hey, hey. Hi, how are you doing? All right, so this is for Harry. I understand that in the Jewish community that you guys have a lot of organizations, so the question I pose to you is, what is your suggestion for African Americans to be able to better organize within our communities? And is that polite? Much respect and due diligence, brother. We appreciate everything that you do. But my question is, and how we get posted is, in any way or form, can you explain us that do you subscribe to Freemasonry and or are meditations, what meditations do you have?
Are you a Mason? Do you subscribe to Freemasonry? Cool, bro. I can ask Harry how can we help ourselves. Hello, Harry. We actually have a Jewish community, a great respect for our elders, for the rabbis, so to say, the grand rabbi in the community. That doesn't mean across the board everyone has been righteous for the last 2,000 years, but we have a rabbi, you have structure and trust. So for example, if you know I had trouble paying my bills one week, I go to the rabbi and I talk to him. He's got people in the synagogue who's got a little bit of extra money, they give it to the rabbi, he gives it to me. So there's no one is left alone in my community. No one is allowed to feel alone. Everyone kind of knows each other's business. I go pray 3 times a day in my community. So we're all in each other's faces. No one is alone. Every Shabbat, I have Friday night meals with other people in my community. Saturday afternoon meals with other families, inviting families over to break bread. This evolves into organizations that takes care of each other, which, you know, looks like a conspiracy, but it's actually teamwork. We have our own ambulance services. In every city that there's a Jew, we finance on our own philanthropic dollars our own ambulance service. We don't rely on 911. When I'm in an emergency, I don't call 911. I call the Jewish ambulance service, and they're there like that. They take care of me like a brother. That's something that could be easily scaled out, but I think it starts with respect for, you know, hierarchy, community, for your elders. How do I suggest you do it? I think there's a lot of tears of healing that's going to go on. I was talking about it before. I think there's a lot of mental warfare raged against your community today. So I'm learning in school. You know, the glorifying presidents who were on record saying that African Americans need less sleep and feel pain less, you know? So how are we in school glorifying the presidents? There's psychological warfare going on, which breaks down communities. So I think that you have to come up against something that I couldn't even imagine about that battle. And it's going to come from your leaders to help unite you. So you got guys trying, my brother Black's trying, you got other guys trying. It shouldn't matter necessarily the religion they are or what truths they practice. We're all in the same community, so it's gonna have to be teamwork. That's the first step.
All right.
Brother Black's got a question.
See, real quick.
I have to ask you this question.
Eat that food, yo.
First, I find it very interesting that you want me to chime in on a statement that he used to antagonize me, put the show right. Even more interesting, I find it it's almost tantalizing to hear a black man ask a pale Jew,
what can we do?
Can you suggest to us how we can get organized as a black community?
As a black man.
Shut up. Right?
That's a cool question.
It is what it is. And I can't ask the questions. I have to give the answers. So, I am not in the Masonic Lodge. And when I was in the Masonic Lodge, I was a Supreme Deputy Grand Master. My jurisdiction went from Canada down to the Mason-Dixon line. And I went through the school, haven't been off the trial enough to die, and will be tried again under one scary kid as a brother. But the school of thought that I went into by Dr. York, we was taught to go into the school to understand what the heck black people are thinking when they go into it so we can communicate with them better. Dr. York had a school of Christianity, Holy Tabernacle Ministries. Dr. York had an Egyptian school, the Egyptian Church of Mass. Dr. York had a Muslim school in the Islam of our community. Dr. York had a Nubian Islamic Hebrew school where he tried to bridge the gap between Muslims and Hebrews, where he was known as Rabbi Yeshua. Okay? And previous to all of that, he came in as Abu Dharakata. But he said it was too heavy when he came in as an Egyptian. So he started for what he called the lesser missionaries. He then transcended those schools to an extent and erected what is called the Masonic Lodge. Anything that our people found themselves in when we thought they were being misinformed, he said it behooves us to behave as our community's parents when we're more conscious, to find out what they're thinking and what they're learning so you can communicate with them. Because verily, if I spoke to a child about 50 cents and I made a mistake in acknowledging it's 70 cents, if I called 2 chains, 5 chains, it would be a defense mechanism. They would laugh at me and wouldn't listen to me. But if I go to a Jew or a brother who says he's in a Hebrew Israelite school of thought, And I began to recite Barashimba, Hashimba, and all that. And he says, well, in the beginning, God created the heavens and earth, and started forming the void, dogs, water, faces, and spirit, and all who was what. They would think I'm actually into religion. I really don't care about it. I only learned these things so I can communicate better with my brothers and sisters. So the only reason I was in the Masonic Lodge was just so I could talk to my brothers who were happy that they were free and accepted by white people, principal Masons who have an honorary status, meaning they're not actually Freemasons, they were just an elite group of black people that white folks appreciated more than other Masons that are considered clandestine. So the spookism about Freemasonry and Hollywood and all that trying to apply to me, I'm actually flattered that you think I'm that huge, but the brother of mine was only in Freemasonry when he was broke. And I was learning. I wasn't like this then. I was broke as shit when I was in Freemasonry, and all I could do was read PDF downloads because I couldn't even afford the books. Thank you, my brother.
All right, give it up for that. But I'm going to try to know before Harry gets here. Hold on, Harry. I know you want to get out of here, but it's not all you want. I'm the flamethrower, goddammit. The flame is my intellectual brother. But see, what we have to understand, Harry will stand here and tell you how much wealth he got. He was born with a silver spoon in his mouth. But Harry is not going to tell you that he received that stuff through stolen goods. It was his mother and father who had stolen from your mothers and fathers. Do you hear me? So that's how he got his guy. He didn't get it through hard work.
His face, then.
He received
stuff. I'm going to lie.
But goddamn, it's the truth.
That's he didn't see you, so.
Why do you think they call themselves Goldstein and Rubenstein?
Woo!
Silverstein! That's your stuff, man! Come on, jewelry! Jewelry! That's your stuff! But he gonna act like he got it through hard work. Hell no, Harry. You ain't gonna play that small time stuff all the rest of the
game. You got frontal? I got a whole piece.
So when he left Egypt in the story, the Pharaoh gave him midwives, servants, like items and everything.
Okay. Yep.
Yeah. So my question is, everybody who is technically considered a Jew would be those Egyptians that was given to them. So why is it that it's important to speak of an Israelite narrative when the original occupants of that group was primarily Egyptians?
Right. And as far as tracing wealth and wisdom, I don't think Egypt is the source.
Anybody ask you that?
I don't think Egypt is the source. I think there's an evolution to it, so no one here can come and say, you know, before Egypt was the Sumerian cultures, perhaps, who also had gold, wealth, and information that was aligned with the sciences. So, the Israelite narrative is an unfolding narrative of a global redemption. When you have around the world today, billions of people talking about the house of King David, that's a platform
we can
align ourselves. So, we're not going to go a couple billion deep and say, let's drop it, because there was a nation around the same time as this also had wisdom. We're going to move forward and say our common denominator is so strong we can build a good future out of this. That's my answer. But listen, so I got a flight to Israel. Right?
I got your money. I got to go.
One more.
Thank you.
Are we truth seekers? And Brother Polite, I want to say peace to you. And Harry, one thing that you've spoken about this whole debate has been mythology. You have not talked about any factual evidence. You have not talked to 740 AD. Your people in Eastern Europe converted to Europe. That's a fact. You are not Abraham. You are not the seed of David. Nor Solomon. That is the truth. And the first thing out of your mouth when you debate, the first thing was an insult to our brother Polite. Brother Polite is representing us, correct? And who is Brother Harry representing?
Damn.
Right? And the first thing he said about Brother Polite, he said Brother Polite had a calcified penis. Now, we all know that African people, right, are born with their kingdom when activated. And we know, factually, that every other group on this planet that is not African, right, is not a Homo sapiens. One. And they're born in a kingdom when
they're not African. That's not a question, bro.
Can you tell him what the hell we've been through since 1492?
He made that book, Why Blacks Should Celebrate
Knowledge.
Yeah.
It's to bring that nigga out of white people. Because they are the original niggas, not niggas. Italian nobility that establishes an Ethiopian king. We're talking about the first nigger was the white man. He produced it.
Nigger in America's thing.
So I normally apply the term nigger or white people or black people applying the sciences that white people instilled in them to promote their own distinction, degradation, or propagation of messages that lead to fratricide. So I believe when Harry was speaking on my pineal gland being calcified, I believe it was an act of emotion. I believe he was losing his composure. I believe he thought he was going to talk to an uneducated Negro. And I know today when he reviews these tapes, he's going to say to himself, he not only kicked my ass, I underestimated him greatly. He thought my dissertation would be super saturated with racial convictions. I just spread it out. So I'm not offended because I have tough skin, and when we go through certain diatribes, I believe people are allowed to throw jabs. I've been through this with the brothers on the streets with the plastic spikes. That can implicate me emotionally to feel lesser than what I felt about from the time he walked in. Whatever level I appreciated him for, I appreciate his message about unity.
I just don't appreciate how he deflects about the relevant social political clauses that we find to make it so contentious with him when he chooses not to identify with them, or doesn't yield to the truth when he say, if you want compliance from us for cooperation, you must first tell the truth, and secondly, rid yourself of the very religion that has been used to incapacitate our people. If he were to do that, I would take into consideration some of the things he has to offer, because he says a lot of intelligible things. But unfortunately,
you still suffering that bullshit. Word.
I cannot work with a habit that will allow the sucking of young babies' penises. And I mean it seriously. He has to strongly condemn it. He has to separate himself from it. He has to say that his own kind has lost their mind. He cannot be here saying, I'm not going to judge, when he knows that our legal system is filled with them as the judges. That's keeping us behind the wall. So we being judged by their people all the time. And when it's time to judge them for their false birth control, when it's time to judge them and ask them to atone for their sins,
revenge
for what they've done to us as a people, he passes the buck all the time. So again, in regards to the brother's question, when it comes to debates, and I've done a lot with my brothers, I'm well seasoned. It makes me smile. I never take it personal, because I believe that at the day we're just pushing our troops, and hopefully the great things, the greater part of whatever he says and I says will resonate with you and somehow cause you to achieve greater goals and greater heights in spirituality. That's the purpose of this presentation. So I appreciate you contributing, because it makes it interesting. And I know I didn't come short of your expectations, though I believe I'm probably going to move a little bit higher. So I thank you, I appreciate it.
Bow down, Harry.
I appreciate that also. As many angry faces as I saw tonight, I got a lot of love. So many people came over to me and gave me a lot of love. They may not agree with me, and that, you know, touched my heart. I really appreciate it. Makes me feel like my trip to Israel here wasn't for naught. I planted some seeds. As information evolves, I'm going to circle back and see how they all stand and lay on.
Last question, please.
You ain't want to give that up.
Has to do with reparations.
There you go. You gonna answer and run away, son? You're Harry like he fighting runs away all the time, Harry. Man. You know the moves.
Harry, what do you feel about reparations for black people? What do you feel about reparations for black people? Your people receive reparations, Holocaust, the state of Israel, and I wanted to know, can you use the resources that you guys have acquired and built to help us acquire reparations in America and other parts of the world where we've been, you know, dehumanized and used?
I strongly believe in reparations, however, I strongly disbelieve in the current fiat system that we're using, not backed by gold. So if you want to get paid monopoly dollars, I don't know if that's going to do much. Land, electricity, food, plants.
Alright, one of the things we're gonna stop doing, man, stop asking a pan of white man for help. We don't want to help us. Come on, asking a pan of white man for reparations. We gotta help us, man. We got to help us. Ain't no white man gonna get your ass out of this thing. Stop playing, man. I'm tired of this foolishness.
Hey.
We put up some of the newer DVDs. We still have some books on the table. We still here signing books, taking pictures, having a lovely time. I hope you really enjoyed yourselves. Thank you for supporting the House of Consciousness. Woo! New comment. Woo! Peace to the family out there. I love y'all so much. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Space.